Hey guys, it's me again. So I figured I will quickly share with you my Knowles Farm Sense haul. And this arrived very fast. He did pour really fast. I think it was either on time or a week or two before the turnaround time. And it came really, really nicely packaged. I mean, in true fashion, as Travis always does. And this is how it was packaged. It had, you know, the thank you folded over with a lot of these little guys in there that I already took out. And I've actually already warmed through one. So I'll also share with you my review on that. I really do like how there is a receipt and kind of keeps track of what you ordered. I usually save these, and then a business card, and obviously Travis is the owner from Knowles Farm Sense. And then he also puts in a thank you. And here it gets into, oh snap, it talks about kind of snap and share your pictures on his Instagram page, Facebook, and tips for melting and how to best warm his wax. And then, as always, I love when vendors do this. Personal note, it says, Christine, thank you so much. Hope you're all doing well. Enjoy, Travis. So really nice. I mean, again, when a lot of these vendors, and I think a lot of the community doesn't really understand this, but a lot of these vendors don't just do this full time. They have this as a side gig. So to be able to take the time and write a note and share and be thoughtful as a business owner, in addition to having another job, is completely amazing. And I just have to say kudos to those vendors who do that and have the balance, right? I talk about this all the time with my work-life balance. So to be able to do it, it's just kudos and hats off. So Travis, love your stuff, and let's dive in. All right. So first off, I'm going to get off with the one with everybody was talking about on our Knowles Farm Live. And my list was, I think, about 10-ish, maybe. But I literally have two drawers of his stuff here in my office and loaves. And I was just like, as much as I love his stuff and I love a lot of these vendors, I was like, I can't warm through it fast enough. So anyway, I went in. I wanted to support and I was super excited, but I didn't go as crazy as I wanted to. So the first one up is Stay, Stay, Stay. And again, this is from the Taylor Swift pre-order, his pre-order. So all of the names of the wax blends are her songs. And so this is Stay, Stay, Stay. And this is Caramelized Vanilla, Sea Salt, Macadamia, Tonka Bean, and Coconut Blossom. So we were talking about this on the live, that it reminds you of a Sol de Janeiro scent. Then we said, oh, maybe it smells like Vanilla Waves from Scentsy. And so we were all going back and forth. Now, let me tell you something. A lot of this was intriguing to me on the scent notes because I am obsessed with his Beach Evenings and his Beach Evenings and Cookies. But his Beach Evenings is amazing. It's a great performer. It's kind of like his take on Beach Nights or Beach Treats or that typical oil, but he just has like something different. I feel like it's a little more creamier, a little more romantic. And it doesn't punch you in the face. I don't know if it's a mixture of like a coconut blossom or the ginger in it, or it's just a really nice creamy blend. And so I'm completely obsessed with that blend. And I saw some of these scent notes sounded similar. Now, the only thing that I was really nervous about, and I was going to get two bags, but I got one bag, is the Caramelized Vanilla. So me and Caramel have a love-hate relationship. So if you just watched my nice gift from Anya, I am not a fan of Scentsy Caramel. I get a burnt note. It's very headache inducing to me, very sweet. I don't like that type of caramel. So now on cold, this is super, super good. You get all of those. You get the macadamia, you get the tonka bean, you get a slight hint of that coconut blossom. is so good, so creamy. That sea salt, almost kind of like when you have a caramel, a sea salt caramel, if you've ever had, like, there's not chocolate, but like a sea salt caramel. That's kind of what I'm getting when I stick my face in this. It's like, oh, I just opened a box of sea salt caramels. So very creamy, very smooth. Okay, so let me tell you, I had one of these guys right here, one of these chunks. I put it in one of my warmers here in my open concept. And I've also been kind of not warming as much or warming a lot because my son's nose has been really runny and I'm like, maybe it's what I'm warming. And I'm like, oh my God, you know, what do you mean I can't warm wax? But I think it's just allergies or something else. However, I did have this one cube going and it was in my open concept and it warped up the stairs. It warped into my office and it was super strong. Now, very, very good. However, one chunk goes a long way. So will I say that I loved it? No. It was very, very sweet. It was definitely 100 times, if not 120 times better than Scentsy's caramel. However, I did have to shut it off midday. It was just really, really strong. It was really, really good, just really, really strong. And so I'm just gonna say that if you like sweet, caramelized, vanilla, creamy blends, I highly recommend you give this one a try. And again, a lot goes a long way. I mean, this is a big chunk. But I literally just put it in one of my warmers and I was like, let's see what happens. I did not stack it all over. But if you did, just be on the air side of caution that it is a very good blend, but a strong one. So that is stay. All right. Another one I'm super excited for, and I just talked about it, was Midnight Rain. Now, I got two bags. I thought that I only got one, but I'm super excited that I got two. I couldn't remember when I literally was on my way to dinner when I was like, oh my God, I gotta place this order and barely had service. So this was Midnight Rain. This is Beach Evenings and Blackberry. And again, I'm a sucker for his Beach Evenings, so I just had to. Oh my God, this is so good. This is really creamy because of the beach evenings and that blackberry is just taking it up a notch. I think beach evenings and blackberry and or beach evenings and cookies and blackberry, Travis, would be an amazing blend. And I don't know if you even offer that, but beach evening cookies and blackberry, that'd be like a blackberry cookie. Oh my God, that would just be like heaven. This is so good. I mean, I think I have, again, two bags of his Beach Evenings, but this is such a good blend. I am here for it. This is just so amazing. So if you like beach nights or beach type treats, again, this one is different because it's his take on it, and I personally like it, but this is, you've got to get into it. I'm so glad I got two bags. So that's Midnight Rain. All right. This one was the wild card in this mix. This is a Lover. Look at how pretty those colors are. This is teakwood, sandalwood, amber, ginger, peppercorn, and tobacco leaf. And again, I'm getting into back to tobacco scents. So I was like, I have so many bakery items. I'm like, I need to branch out. And this reminds me of something else. It almost kind of reminds me of, I grew up in New York, and I don't know if it's a New York-based store, but this, when I smelt it the first time when I opened this box, and when I'm smelling it again, I smelt this earlier in the week. There used to be a store, and I grew up in New York, and maybe if Steph watches this, she'll know. There's a store called Crabtree and Evelyn. And literally, that's what this smells like. It literally smells like I just walked into Crabtree and Evelyn, which is very heavy, kind of not potpourri, but it's almost kind of like a mixture of all these body care products. You get, you know, you can get floral body care, you can get very fresh body care, And I don't know if it's maybe because of the ginger and the sandalwood and the teak wood in this. But this is just very, I think you have to like sandalwood. You have to like teak wood. The amber's there too. It's kind of just creaming it out a little bit. I don't get much peppercorn. I'm getting more of the tobacco leaf than I am getting peppercorn. This is just really good. This would be more of a bedroom bathroom melt for me. But that's what it smells like to me. It smells like I just walked into a Crabtree and Evelyn, kind of like floral, kind of body care kind of shop. Definitely a nice romantic kind of bedroom bathroom scent. Okay, this one, last but not least, is Fearless. This is lemon, cake mix, butter, mandarin zest, sugar, and vanilla. Now, the reason why I got this was because of the cake mix, butter, and the mandarin zest. I was like, this smells like a lemon bakery, but different. So that is Fearless. Look at how pretty those colors are. So I watched Martha and I heard her review and I was like, let's see what mine's gonna be. So I almost kind of get like a lemon kind of, not Meyer lemon, not a cleaning lemon, but almost kind of like a cereal mix kind of lemon. So like if you like Rose Girl Cereal Killer, if you like cereal blends, I don't know why I pick up on that. Maybe it's because of the butter and the sugar and the vanilla, but I'm picking up more of a cereal mix. There's no milk in this or sugar milk. Maybe it's the sugar that's making it like cereal blend. Almost kind of like a fruity Fruit Loop blend. This is good. I mean, you have to like lemon. So if you don't like lemon, don't get this, because that is primarily the prominent note. But I love lemon, and I love lemon bakery. So this is really good. It's just not heavy bakery forward. So if you like lemon and you don't like bakery, this one is a good one to try, because I feel like it kind of gets you into bakery, but it doesn't get you into bakery. It's a fruity blend, but there could be the bakery there with the cake mix and that sugar and vanilla. I wish I got another bag of this one. This one's really, really good. So that is Fearless. So happy I was like on the fence if I needed another lemon bakery, but I'm glad that I went and then got it. All right, and then what Travis does all the time, it's so cute, such a good idea, is the Waste Not Chunk. And this is just, they have no idea what the scents are. It's whatever's left in the pour pot and layered. Mine kind of looks like there's two chunks in here. So I'm kind of getting a little bit of a, and I don't know if it's this one. No, this one is more, there might be coffee in that. Almost kind of like his Cali coffee. That's good. This one I'm getting more of like a clean. So I don't know if it's the one from the clean. I think it was clean. And I wish I got that blend. It was the laundry strawberry pound cake blend. I wish I got that. So thank you so much for this. And then I'm super excited that I got this one, because I was watching Martha's haul and I'm like, oh my God, I hope I get that as a sample. And I did. So I'm so excited to try this. This is Potter's Brew. Thank you so much, Travis. This is vanilla bean, sugar, heavy cream, orange zest, butterscotch, and caramel. Now, again, we talked about caramel, we talked about butterscotch. But still, anyway, I wanted to try it because it's got vanilla and cream, and what's not to love? So, and I was hoping that it would smell like this. So I like this because the caramel, I mean, even though it's there, it's not super heavy. It's more heavy in stay. This is good. Oh my God, I'm so excited. I'm going to put this one in my office and try it out this week. I'm so excited. So this is Potter's Brew. So excited to try that sample. So that's it, guys. That is my Knowles Farm Scents haul. I am so excited it came. Like I said, I already started warming it. I'm probably also going to warm Midnight Rain this week. I just am so excited for his wax. Excited for these blends. You definitely outdid yourself this time. Everybody just keeps getting bigger and better. And I'm so happy that we are all a supportive community here in the wax community. So thank you so much for watching today, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Take care.